maximum as well as minimum development point of view. Individual is developing, how his standard of life is value is improved. These all things we are going to understand in this lecture. So determinants of human development, the three factors alone are considered while preparing HDL. The three aspects they have specified while calculating the HDL to make simple and easy. Instead of absolute value, average of all three values are given. Not any individual values we are finding an average value for all three aspects. First is life expectancy, second is educational achievement, and the third is income data, that means that is the standard of living. So first of all, life expectancy, they have specified one chart. In that, what is life expectancy? What is expected number of years a person will live at the time of birth of the population of the country determines the value. If it is less than 50 years, the country is said to be deficient in health. Higher the life expectancy, better the HDL. So here they have specified the individual survival period, duration, the age. If the individual is less than 50 years from the birth, then our country is in a deficient form, it is in the negative form. If it is more than 50, then we can say as in the positive development. Second is literacy or knowledge. To know the quantum of the knowledge, again, literacy is the percentage calculated. People in the age group of 15 years and above are included, two aspects are included, number of years of schooling, expected number of the years of schooling. The gap between the expected and annual, actual number of years of schooling is taken to derive the value. What is the individual's age and what is expected? Suppose from the point of view of the development, infrastructure, the school facilities, colleges facilities, our country is deriving one expected number of years of schooling and one is what is actual. From that we can find out what is the level of education in our country and what is good standard of living. Then in good standard of living we can say pure drinking water facility, medical service, good sanitization, infant mortality percentage that we have already understood. Undernourished and malnutrition status, the proper amount of calories, proteins, vitamins, carbohydrate, the individual is getting or not. If the person is below 5 of age, the protein fat availability is calculated, he is getting a good proportion of food or not. So this all we can say that it is a part of an income parity. That is, we can say that is the income index is that is the per capita gross national income. If I am earning properly, if my national income or the individual's income is proper, then I can get a proper standard of living. So, important aspects. What are included in HDL? So, they get the maximum value of HDL is 1, which is based on three standards. Over again, listen, the last point we have studied regarding the PQL, the physical quality of life index, it was calculated from 100 mark. Here it is calculated in 1 part, 0 to 1 part. The value range between 0 to 1. The country whose HDL is closer to 1 is considered more developed. If the country's HDL, suppose or India's HDL, suppose, is 0.97, it's closer to 1, then our development is more. If it is closer to 0, then it is less developed. So, according to 2014, Norway ranked 1 with 0.944, but India ranked 0.609, point ranked 130 out of 188 countries. The country Norway, out of 188 countries, where HDL is overall approx around 0.94. So rank is completely more developed compared to India, and India rank is 130. India's HDL is 0.609. Human development indicators by some countries of the word HDR, they are specified in the tabular form. The country name HDL is the value and the rank. The calculation of the average part between 0 to 1, over all three aspects, that means literacy, life expectancy, and standard of living. This we are finding out the average. They are converting into the unit 0 to 1 and then we are giving the rank on that. So if it is closer to 0, it will be high. If it is less than near about 0, then it will be the low. Sometimes we are comparing with the past years. If it is stable same, then there is no development and no decrement in that. So gross national income, average life expectancy, expected year importance to education. This source is from the Economic Survey 2015-16 and SBI of the report 2015. GNI stands for gross national income. LEB stands for life expectancy of birth. So here we have specified the rank. So from 188 countries, the country Norway is getting first, America is 8, China 90, India 130, Pakistan 147, Nigeria 28. So these all countries have specified the rank. From that they compared in Norway, we can say that there is a more development compared to America. It is slightly lower compared to China. It is most likely lower than that. After that, India, Pakistan, and so on. So by this, from this data, we can get a derived conclusion. The human development in the Norway is more, so it is stands in the first place, whereas India stands at 130 place. So now what are the importance of human development? So they have specified total six importance. The first is HPI is complete as it is not only a economic factor but also includes social welfare, giving importance to education and health. We are including education and health in this with the standard of living. HDI indicates a policy making economic development good to achieve the objective of the human welfare. If there is a human welfare or not, we are finding out that also in HDI. True progress. Economic progress plus social progress. HDI, human welfare is economic progress. Machinery point of view as well as social welfare. Schooling part, education part, life expectancy part, standard of living part, this also things we are including in. SDI is a function. A rise in SDI indicates the health and education have improved in the country. It is a functional part. If the country's education and health is getting better and better, then we will get a proper SDI report. Our country is also improving in that. Developing countries get an idea to where there is a scope for development and which different directions should government go working into SDI. We can come to know the conclusion where the government is lacking. That department or in that area the government will improve. SDI is a progressive initiative. It is progressive. If we think in all three aspects, if we find the averages, then we come to know what country is making development or not. Even here they have specified the limitations, three limitations. Only three social indicators are included in SDI. Only three indicators they have got, not the other indicators they have got. All the indicators are given equal weightage. The weightage is similar for life expectancy or for education or for standard of living. So in real situation it is not possible. The main priority of the individual should be standard of living, after that the education or the can need survival part of the life expectancy. Human it is not accurate expression because it shows the we can't compare properly. We can't compare regarding the population what we suppose there will be the more development. So these things may be possible because the population of the country is low. Compared to India, the population is approximately around 130 crores. So it is difficult to arrange all this facility in a short duration. So that may be the limitation. So like HDI or other indicators, we can find out general development index, HPI that is human poverty index, TA technological achievement index, and HCI human consumer index. So these all parts will include as an indicator, but the four indicators they have specified is national income, regarding per capita income, PQLI, that is physical quality of life, and HDI, that is human development index. So I conclude this chapter. You should solve the exercise from the textbook. For doubt, any doubts, queries, you can contact me. Okay, thank you.